الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد. We're now going to go in, inshallah ta'ala, in the explanation of the kitab مقدمة الأجرمية. We're going to speak about the eight anwa, the eight types of things that we do i'rab of. So last week what we said was, we said we do i'rab of one and two. So we said we do i'rab of ism mudhar, صح? And we also said the fi'l fi'l mudhari'. And from the ism mudhar, we brought out how many? We brought six things out of it. The six things that we brought out of it is, number one, ism مفرد, اسم مفرد, جمع التكسير, جمع المذكر, يا الجمع المؤنث, yeah, and المثنى, and last but not least, الأسماء الخمسة, and the fi'l mudari', we said, it's also two that come out of it. Number one and number two. Number one is fi'l al-mudari' alladhi lam yattasil bi-akhirihi شيء, and الأفعال الخمسة. So today what we're going to do, inshallah ta'ala, is we're going to go through each one, what it is. So we're going to go through what اسم مفرد is. We're going to go through جمع التكسير, what it is. We're going to go through جمع المذكر السالم, جمع المؤنث السالم, المثنى, الأسماء الخمسة, فعل المضارع الذي لم يتصل بآخره شيء, and أفعال الخمسة. So we understand it in great details, inshallah ta'ala. That's what we're going to do today. And also what we're going to do is i'rab. We're going to mention i'rab, the opposite of i'rab, which is bina, the opposite of it, and the types of i'rab. That's what we're going to do, inshallah, today's class, inshallah ta'ala. So let's start with ism mufrad, okay? Let's start with what a ism mufrad is. This is just a recap of last lesson. So before I go in, this is the tricky thing. Al-mufrad is the opposite of four things. Okay. Al-mufrad is the opposite of four things. The first one is ما يقابل المثنى والجمع. The The first one is ما يقابل المثنى والجمع. That which is the opposite of dual and plural. And this is the one you take in the chapter of باب الإعراب. In باب الإعراب, when you hear the word المفرد, it means the opposite of المثنى والجمع. But when you're in باب المنادى ولا منافية للجنس, it is ما يقابل المضاف. When you are in باب المنادى ولا النافية للجنس. When you're in the chapter of باب المنادى ولا النافية للجنس, the مفرد is the opposite of المضاف. Okay? It is the opposite of المضاف. It's not the opposite of dual and singular. What does مضاف mean? Don't worry, it's going to come to you at the ending of the book. The third one is ما يقابل الجملة. ما يقابل And this is in the chapter of باب المبتدأ والخبر. When you're in باب المبتدأ والخبر, the word المفرد, it is the opposite of a sentence. It's the opposite of a جملة. In the chapter of باب المبتدأ والخبر, when you hear the word اسم مفرد, it means something different. Am I, if you hear the word مفرد, if you hear مفرد. And last but not least is ما يقابل المركب. And that's the باب, when you're at the chapter of العلم. The chapter when you're at العلم, the word المفرد, it means ما يقابل المركب. That which is the opposite of a compounded word. A compounded word. So, the word مفرد, you cannot just say singular like that. Okay, because it's not necessarily singular. It's only singular in one of the chapters of grammar, which is باب الإعراب. So, باب الإعراب, which is the one that we're going to be doing, if you hear the word اسم مفرد, singular noun, It is ما يقابل المثنى أو الجمع أو المجموع. لذلك the تعريف of اسم مفرد is in this chapter of باب الإعراب is ما ليس مثنى ولا مجموعا ولا ملحقا بهما ولا من الأسماء الخمسة. صح؟ That's what it means in this chapter. Are we all together? Don't confuse it in other chapters. Because later when we come to مبتدأ and خبر, we're going to take the أنواع الخبر, right? The types of خبر. We're going to take خبر which is مفرد, خبر which is شبه جملة, and then we're going to take جملة. You're going to be مفرد. And you're seeing a word that's plural, but it's been called an اسم مفرد. And you're like, how is that possible? We're not looking at whether it's plural or not. We're looking at whether it's a sentence or not this time. In باب المبتدأ والخبر. Are we all together? So the one that we're referring to here, today's class, is the first one. It's the one that we call singular noun. That which is the opposite of the word يقابل in the Arabic language means what? Opposite. صح? The word قابل, يقابل, مقابلة means what? That's why when you go to receptions, what's written at the bottom? Al-istiqbal. Istiqbal means what? You're going to face this person, the receptionist. You're meeting each other. Muqabala is going to happen, صح? Are we all together? And then muqabala means when you go and you meet someone. So the word ما يقابل المثنى means that which goes on different angle or the opposite side of a mufrad, which is a muthanna and a majmu', which is a plural. Okay? So for example, in this chapter, we're going to say these three, it's going to come to us inshallah, don't worry. Let's just focus on this one now. Ja'a Muhammadun wal fata. Okay? So Muhammad is what? It's a singular noun, so it's a mufrad. And al fata is a what? Is a what? It is singular. Ja'a is a what? Ja'a Muhammadun wal fata. Idhan Muhammad is a what? Fa'il. Don't worry, you don't have to busy yourself with that now. If you don't know it, no problem. Fa'il is a subject. It's the one that did the coming. And fata is a what? It's also a? Sorry. Forget that for now. Okay. But there's waw al-atf here, okay? Which is going to come to us later. And then, fa'il, Muhammad came, and also the fatah came, which is also a subject as well. Muhammad has a particular sign, which is its marfu'. Don't worry, we're going to come to that soon. And it's marfu'un? Bil-dhamma. The dhamma is showing. Well, fata is also what? It's also marfu'. It's also what? Marfu'. And it's also marfu'. Bi? It's also marfu'un bil dhamma. The reason why you can't see it is, that's why we say mana'a min dhuhuriha. The reason why it's not going to become clear to you is the harf illah. There's a sick letter at the ending, which is waw, alif, and ya. Don't worry, this is not something that concerns you, but I'm just doing it formality. بِالضَّمَّةِ مَنَعَ مِنْ ظُهُورِهَا التَّعَذُّرِ. Okay? So what concerns us here right now in this example is جَاءَ مُحَمَّدٌ. All that concerns us is the name Muhammad and Al-Fatah. And I specifically chose this example. One that is ظاهر and one is مُقَدَّر. Because later we're going to, when we talk about the ta'rif of i'rab, I'm going to mention it there inshallah ta'ala. Okay. So we now know what a mufrad is, right? What is a mufrad? It is something that isn't four things. A mufrad, ism mufrad, in this chapter of i'rab, it can't be four things. It can't be muthanna. It can't be what? Majmu'. It can't be also what? Mulhaqqan bihima. What does it mean, mulhaqqan bihima? You see, there are words in the Arabic language which are dual and are plural, but they have no singular. Al-mufrad is what? Ma laysa, ma laysa muthannan. Wala majmu'an. Wala mulhaqan. Bihima. Wala min al-asma' al-khamsa. Is al-mufrad is what? The following, underline them. ما ليس مثنن ولا مجموعا ولا ملحقا بهما ولا من الأسماء الخمسة. So it's four things. One, two, three, and four. You put your finger up.
You're talking about this only, the first one?
The first one, min bab al-i'rab. The other three types of mufrad, ignore that for now. In this chapter, we're going to focus on the first type of mufrad. Because we're in the chapter of i'rab, right? We know. What is it? ما ليس مثنن, that which is not a مثنى. ولا مجموعا, and it's also not plural. ولا ملحقا بهما, and it also cannot be ملحق. ملحق means it's attributed to the مثنى or the جمع. What does that mean? In the Arabic language, for example, I'll show you. You have Muhammad plus Muhammad. In the Arabic language, it equals what? Muhammadani, right? In the Muhammadani, it comes from two Muhammads, صح? Does that make sense? Does it not? It does. There are words in the Arabic language that are dual. But they don't have no singular. Like the word kilta. Kilta is a muthanna la mufrada lahu. It's a dual that has no singular. This is called mulhaqul muthanna. So called the mulhaq of a muthanna. Meaning it's dealt with as a muthanna, but it's really not a muthanna. Because a muthanna has to be what? It has to come from a singular root, singular word. The kilta is dealt with like a muthanna, but it's not a muthanna. Why is it not a muthanna? It's because it has no singular. Are we all together? This kilta is in the Quran, right? It's in what? It's in the Quran. Like for example, tis'una. Hey, tis'una. Is that plural? Ha. Shall mudhakkar isal. Hey, does it have a singular? Does tis'una have a singular? It doesn't have a singular. The word tis'una, the word. Forget numbers it comes from some, the numbers do. Like the word tis'una doesn't come from tis, and then it becomes tis'una, it doesn't. Are we all together? The word doesn't have a singular. This is called mulhaqul jam'ul mudhakkar salim. We deal with it like a word that's connected to jam'ul mudhakkar salim. Does that make sense? Yes? Huh? It's not singular of the word tis'un, no. No, it's not. Because if you add 9 all day, it's never going to make 90, is it? If you say 9 plus 9, it will never make 90. صح? And the word tis'una didn't come from tis'a. No, it didn't. Are we all together? It didn't come from that root word. Are we all together? Does that make sense? It didn't come from it as a jama', as a plural. Does that make sense? Even that though you're seeing the 9 here, and you're saying tis'a, and untas just means that 0. Some people think like that, صح? هذا ليس بصحيح. This is a new word that you're seeing now. لا مفرد له, it has no مفرد. According to grammarians. Like they deal with it like what? ملحق جمع ذكر السالم. Then the ruling that it takes is a جمع ذكر السالم. So the اسم مفرد cannot be a مثنى. It cannot be a جمع. And it also cannot be ملحقا بهما, these two, these kind of ones. ولا ملحقا بهما. وَلَا مِنَ الْأَسْمَاءِ الْخَمْسَةِ, and it cannot be from the أَسْمَاءُ الْخَمْسَةِ. And أَسْمَاءُ الْخَمْسَةِ are what? أَبُوكَ, أَخُوكَ, حَمُوكَ, فُوكَ, and ذُو عِلْمٍ. Okay? Which we're going to see, inshallah. Which we're going to see, inshallah ta'ala. We're going to see what are al-asma'ul khamsa. We've now done, inshallah ta'ala, ism mufrad. We've got an understanding of ism mufrad. We're now going to go into jam'ul taqsir. Okay, jam'ul taqsir is what? ما تغير بناء مفرده. That's a جمع التكسير. It is ما تغير بناء مفرده. It is the word that its singular changed. So it's ما تغير بناء مفرده. This word, it used to be طالب. Okay, it used to be what? طالب. Let's break this down. طالب means student. Student. A student. Just one student. Okay? A student. Just one student. A student. Okay, a student. Let's break this word down. We have ta, which has a fatha on it, plus lam, ta, no, it's an alif. We have an alif, ta, plus lam, ta, lib, which has kasra on it, plus ba, which is talib. The word became what? طالب, صح؟ طالب. This word, make it into a plural now. So you say, طلاب. Okay, wait. This is what? It's students. It's become what? It's become plural. Let's break the word down. We have a ta plus the ta has a, what does it have on it? There's a dhamma on it. Tul la, it has a fatha on it. Alif plus ba, and it became what? Okay, the word, when it was singular, which is talib, did it change when it became plural? Did the word change? It did change. The changing that happened is, number one, the shakal changed, meaning the haraka changed. The fatha changed to a dhamma. What also changed is the alif is gone. The alif is gone. And then after that, a lam came. And then a new alif came. Okay, it's a what? It's a new alif. It's not the one that was there, came, jumped here. No, it's not. It's a new alif. And then the last word is a ba. The alif here, sorry, the lam here has a fatha on it. And the lam here has a what? A kasra on it. And then what we realized is that when it moved from being singular to plural, the word changed. That's called jam'u taksir. It is ma taghayyara bina'u mufradihi. The structure of the word changes when it moves from being singular to what? To plural. Does that make sense? And even if you take, yeah. Na'am, sahih. So many different changing that happen. Are we all together? The changing happens to the jam'u taksir in six ways. Write this down. So we said that it changes, the singular changes to this way. The changing happens in six ways. Number one. Number two. Number three. number four, number five, and number six. The first one is بالشكل فقط. The first one is, all that changes is the haraka. That the word, it changed, but it changed because of the haraka. For example, an example is, so look at this word. Do they look the same? Ha. That's the singular and the plural. The letters haven't changed. So as you can see, they have the same letters. Like, what is the difference? When I do the haraka on it. When it's singular, is asad. And when I make it plural, it becomes what? Ustun. Does that make sense? That's all it is. أما أسودون, however you want to say it. على أي قول تحتاج إليه. The second one is الزيادة. الزيادة فقط. Let's take that قول. الزيادة فقط. الزيادة فقط means you only add something onto the word. So the word increases and it becomes bigger. Meaning something is added to it, but the haraka is not changed. So what can you see here? What can you see? You can see alif and noon just being added to the word. That's it. The haraka is the same. It's a what? Sin wun. Sin wanun. Forget this last letter. Because it's al waqfu. Doesn't concern you. The haraka hasn't changed. Does it make sense? The haraka hasn't changed. Only thing that's happened here is a ziyada. An additional two letters have been added here, which is an alif and a alif and a noon. The second one is, or the third one is, an-naqsu faqat. An-naqsu. An-naqsuf means something is taken from the word. It is taken from what? Tukhamatun. Tukhamun. Tukhamun. Tukhamatun. He has had a what? What did he have? Ta' marbota. Where's the ta' marbota gone? It dropped. And then this is an-naqsu faqat. It took something away from the word. That's how it changed. This is, remember, this is the singular, al-mufrad, and this is the jam'u, al-taksir. This is the jam'u taksir, and this is the mufrad. Does that make sense? So now what it changed is by the letter of the ta' marbuta going. The fourth one is بالشكل والزيادة. بالشكل والزيادة. بالشكل والزيادة means the haraka changed and something was added to it as well. Where Dhamma? Sorry, it's Dhamma both. I don't know where Fatha here, sorry. So, Tukhamun, Tukhamatun, same. Okay, this by the way, when I say Tukhamun, I'm only doing that because it's min bab al-waqf. It's not that the meem has that haraka on it, okay? So, this one is the shakl. The shakl changes and something is also added to it. Like, Rajulun. Rijalun. So it changes, which is Rajulun. Rijalun. So here what happened? The shakl changed from Ra to Ri. So the shakl changed, which is a haraka. Was ziyada here is what? The alif that's been added to it. The alif that has been added to it. Number five is ash-shakl wal-naqsu. Bishakli. والنقصي. So the word the haraka gets changed and also something is taken from it. An example for that is kitabun and kutubun. So kitabun, kutubun. Here what you can see is ki to ku, ta to tu. So the shakl has changed, the harak has changed. But this time, something's also been taken away from it, which is that there was an alif here. The alif got removed in the plural. It's the opposite of which one? It is the opposite of the fourth one. And last, but not least is, it is bishakli. Bishakli. Waziyadati. And wannaqsi. In other words, the shakl changes. Something's been added to it, and also something's been reduced from it as well. Something's been added, something's been taken away as well. And an example for that is Ghulamun Ghulamun to Ghilmanun. No. Ghulam and Ghilman. So you can see here Ghulam Ghilman. So you can see the shakl has changed from Ghu to Ghi. You can also see the ziyada, which is the lam has an alif on it. And here it doesn't. So there's a there's a naqs here, naqs, which is the alif is missing from here on the lam. There's also a ziyada, which is that the neem has an extra alif on it and the noon. And also the noon is a ziyada. Then it has shakl that is changed. There's an additional things that have been added to it. And there's also things that have been taken away from it. So things have been taken away. Then Jam'u taksir gets changed in these six forms. In those six forms. But this doesn't really give you the way the way or the forms that jam'u taksir come in. And if anybody wants it more, I compiled all of the siyah sarfiyan, morphologically, how jam'u taksir come, and all of the ways that they come. That's something to do with sarf. Okay? Because all you're hearing right now is naqs. But the naqs happens in so many ways. Does that make sense? So this is jam'u taksir. We're now going to go into jam'u al-mu'annath al-thani. We're now going to go into... Does anyone first have a question regarding this? Is it crystal clear? Yeah. Asad, huh? Yeah, the form is broken. And the form of the word from singular to plural gets broken. Like in the breaking here is different. Sometimes it gets broken by just the haraka changing. Sometimes something being added, sometimes something being reduced from it. So now you learnt fa'al and fu'ul, the jam'u dhakr salim, the jam'u taksir comes in. That's one form. Now we're going to go into jam'u al-mu'annath al-salim. Jam' al-mu'annath al-salim. Okay, which is, so from this word it gives us the impression that this word is going to have three qualities, sah? From just looking at the name, three things we have to find in it, which is, it has to be, it's jama' and it's al-mu'annath and it's also al-salim. Okay, it gives us that impression, right? But under scrutiny and deep observation, we realize that it only meets the first two criteria, and the third one is questionable. Some of the scholars, they said it is actually called مَا جُمِعَ بِأَلِفٍ وَتَاءٍ مَزِيدَتَيْنِ. That's the best. There's no short way of saying it. مَا جُمِعَ بِأَلِفٍ وَتَاءٍ مَزِيدَتَيْنِ. Let's look at it. It is, first of all, جَمَع, plural. أَلْمُؤَنَّث means feminine. أَسَّالِم means what? Safe. Safe here means what? It is safe from what the jam'u taksir goes through. Because what does the jam'u taksir happen? What happens to jam'u taksir? The word changes from the singular to the plural, what we just saw right now. This is saying to you, we're safe from that, alhamdulillah. Does that make sense? That's what it means. Salim here means safe from taghyiru bina'u mufaradihi. It is safe from the alternation, the changing of the word from when it was singular. Does that make sense? Like jam'u taksir, it does change. Only that, some of the scholars, they add the jam'u al-mu'annath al-salim under jam'u taksir. And the only difference is that it just shows female, that's it. But it's a broken plural as well. Now we're all together. Some of the scholars, that's what they say. Like, let's not do that. Let's take this opinion, inshallah ta'ala. Which is that jam'u al-mu'annath al-salim, it is. And the reason why we're going to show that it's broken is because, for example, look at the word bint. You have the word bint. Bint. Turn that word into plural. Yeah? Turn that word into, you said banat. Here, what happened? Hey, you can tell me what just took place right now. Huh?
It was changed to the
land. No, what changed first? From the sound to the fatha. So the fatha, look at the word. Bint it was. Shakl changed. Became banat. So it's not salim. Second thing that happened was what? Yeah? So the shakl changed, that's number one. Hey, second thing happened? This is ziyadah here. Third thing is what? An-naqs. Where's the ta? Where is this ta? These are two extra things. This is new ta, alif and ta, ziyada. These are new. Where is this ta gone? It dropped. So the two main things that have happened here, is what? The shekel changed and a naqs happened. That's the two strongest things that have happened here. The shekel changing from bint to banat. And also what's happened is the naqs, something's missing, the ta is missing. Don't think this ta is this ta, it's not. This ta is a new ta that came. This alif and ta are new. This ta is missing. Okay? Are we all together? Okay. In ala kulli hal, what we can say at least is, it's not salim. It's not what? It is not salim. It's not salim. This word is not salim. But they say, the scholars, so we'll just say, because it's become mashhoor like that. It's become famous. But by the way, there are some words that are salim. Some words which are salim. There are. So, are they referring to those ones specifically or not the general jump around the salim? Allahu alam. Anyways. Jam'u al-mu'annath salim, as I just said to you, it's plural female. Jam'u al-mu'annath salim is what? It's plural. Now that I'm just going to mention some important point, I think inshallah ta'ala is worth mentioning. Write this down inshallah ta'ala. Two conditions for the jam'u al-mu'annath salim to happen. Two conditions. Okay, these two situations is a problem for the jam'u al-mu'annath salim, meaning it's no longer considered to be what? Jam'u al-mu'annath salim. These two situations are when it takes it away from being a jam'u al-mu'annath salim. What did we just say right now when we gave the definition of a jam'u al-mu'annath salim? What did we say? مَا جُمِعَ بِأَلِفٍ وَتَائِنْ مَزِيدَتَيْنِ مَا جُمِعَ بِأَلِفٍ وَتَائِنْ مَزِيدَتَيْنِ. It is a word that has an alif and a ta increased on the wording. صحيح, that's what I said. مَا جُمِعَ, the word is made into a plural by adding an alif and a ta at the ending. Like bint, banat, Fatima, Fatimat, Alif and Ata. Okay. Here's a problem, what happens? In some situations, the Alif of the word is not Zaida. It's not Zaida. But rather it's what? Alifun Asliyun. The Alif in there is a Aslul Kerima. It's from the root, it's from the word itself. This is not called a jam'u al-mu'annath salim. Like the word qudat. Okay. For example, Qubat. You have a ta here, alif, right? This alif is biniyatil kalima. It's from the word itself. Qada is alif maqsura, right? Alif mamduda. Then this alif is the aslul kalima. It's part of the word. Are we all together? It is what? It's part of the word. It can't be part of the word. It has to be ziyada. Like the word bint, the alif was not part of the word. It was added on it. And also the ta. Another issue that happens, which is some words, the ta is part of the word and it's not an additional. Like the word amwat. Amwat, the ta here is asliya, is part of the word. Huh? Is what? Asliya. How do you write death in Arabic? This is plural. How do you write singular? How do you write it? So it's from the root word. Are we all together? This is the ta that's there now. These two situations, it's not jamra natisan. So the condition is Alla yakuna al-alifu asliyan. The alif cannot be asliya. Walat ta'u asliya. And the ta of the word cannot be asliya. They both have to be added onto the word, then it becomes jam mu'annath al-salim. Then it becomes what? Jam'u al-mu'annath al-salim. No, that's not. And why is that different from this one? Walana fihi majal. There's not the difference. Bint, the ta is gone, it dropped. Are we all together? Whereas mot, the ta didn't drop. ولذلك موت, you don't, when you say amwat, it's not jam'u al-thani. It's jam'u al-taksir. Amwat is what? Jam'u al-taksir, it's not jam'u al-thani. It doesn't even enter the chapter. Jam'u al-thani. Sah? It's going to benefit you a lot understanding the differences between jam'u al-mudhakkar al-salim, jam'u al-mu'annath al-salim, and also jam'u al-taksir. Because of the sayyara and sayyarat, sahih. No. The ta, sayyara, and sayyarat. By the way, what we have to understand is, generally speaking, and I don't want to go too much into it because we're going to go into the issue of al-mu'annath when we come to mamnu' min as-sarf. Pay attention. The word sayyara, you have sayyara, which means what? A car. This ta, its job is to indicate that this word is a what? A feminine. So is the alif and ta. So every ta marbuta generally that you see in Jam'u al-Salim, what takes its place? The alif and ta marbuta. Because they're doing the same job, which is to indicate that the word is a what? To show that the word is a what? It's a feminine word. Okay? But there's some words that are not without ta'am marbuta, like the word bint and banat, that's the one that's tricky.
Is it an indication that the hamza is there and amwat? That's why you can say that the ta moved and it didn't drop.
Hmm?
Because of the hamza, is it an indication that the hamza is there? That's why we say that the ta moved and it didn't drop.
The reason I don't want to mention why this one is asal and the bint isn't, is a mas'ala tata'allaq bis-sarf. It's a mas'ala connected to sarf. Are we all together? Is an issue connected to what? It's a sarf-related issue. How did this alif come in the first place? Is it an issue of when a word evolves from one root word to another? That's what it is. If any one of you has studied an issue called harfun ama kalimatun taqa'u bayna aduwatayha, a letter that falls in between two words of its enemy, that's what happened to Al-Amwat. Are we all together? But right now, don't busy yourself with how do I distinguish this one from this one. You'll come to it, inshallah. But it's good that you want to know. Okay, we understand what Jam'u al-Salim is. We're now going to go into فعل المضارع الذي لم يتصل بآخره شيء. فعل المضارع الذي لم يتصل بآخره شيء means, as you can see from the name, it is al fi'l al-mudari' al-ladhi lam yattasil bi-akhirihi shay. So I want you to understand here, this is very important. Okay, this is what? It's extremely important. And then this one doesn't need a definition, because the name of it is a definition, صح? It is the fi'l mudari' that nothing connects to it from the ending. What is it that can connect to a fi'l mudari'? Are we all together? What is it that can connect to? So here it says al-fi'l mudari', it's a fi'l mudari' that nothing has connected to it from the ending. The question here is, what can possibly connect to the fi'l? Fi'l mudari'. Are you answering that question? Don't worry. It's three things that can connect to the fi'l mudari'. Three things. Here we're trying to say none of those three should connect to it. The first one is that which makes it af'alul khamsa. Which is basically what? Alif al-Ithnain. Waw al-Jama'ah. And ya al-mu'annatha. Al-mukhataba. Ya al-mu'annatha al-mukhataba. You see? And the other one is Noon al-Tawkeed. Noon al-Tawkeed and Noon al-Niswa. It's also called Noon al-Inatha. Noon al-Niswa. Okay? They can also connect to the ending of the word. Like Yadhabanna. An example would be يَذْهَبَنَّ أَمَّا يَذْهَبْنَا. Sorry, يَذْهَبَ يَذْهَبَن. The Noon al-Tawkeed is two types, ثَقِيلَ and خَفِيفَ. صح? Heavy and light. We'll go to that, inshallah ta'ala, another time. And Noon al-Niswa, which is يَذْهَبْنَا. Noon al-Tawkeed is the Noon of emphasis, and Noon al-Niswa is the Noon of feminine. يَذْهَبْنَا. These two, when they connect to the fi'l mudari', they make it what? Mabni. Means no longer i'rab. Noon al-Tawkeed and Noon al-Niswa, when they both connect to the fi'l mudari', they make it what? Mabni. Okay, it's what? It's mabni. Noon al-Tawkeed, it's mabniyun ala al-fath. And when it's Noon al-Niswa, it is mabniyun ala al-sukun. Okay? It's no longer i'rab. It's no longer this chapter that we're studying today. The chapter of Babul i'rab. It's not in that chapter. When these two connect to it, it leaves that whole discussion. If it's af'alul khamsa, which we're going to come to inshallah ta'ala, which is aliful ithnaini, wawul jama'a, ya al-mu'annathat al-mukhataba. If any of those three connect to it, it becomes a what? it becomes something else. And af'alu al-khamsa, we're going to take it. It's from the eight things that we mentioned, right? So you learnt here the difference between af'alu al-khamsa and fi'lu al-mudari'i alladhi lam yattasil bi akhirih shay is what? That af'alu al-khamsa is fi'lu al-mudari'i alladhi ittasala bi akhirih shay. Fi akhirih shay. That the af'alu al-khamsa is all it is a fi'l mudari' that some things have connected to it at the ending. Which is what? Alif al-Ithnain, Waw al-Jama'ah, or Ya al-Mu'anathat al-Mukhatabah. Am I making sense? No. Yes. Huh? Why do I feel like I'm not making no sense? Everything is one. So this is called Mabni. So this is Mabni ala Sukun, as you can see. And this is Mabni ala al-Fath. And Mabni ala al-Fath. Okay? Anyone have any question? No? No questions? You look confused. Let me repeat it one more time. The فعل المضارع الذي لم يتصل بآخر شيء is one of the eight that we took, right? So as you can see from the name, it's a فعل مضارع. الذي, the فعل مضارع لم يتصل بآخر شيء, nothing has connected to it from the ending. So what is it that can connect to the word? That's the question you're going to ask yourself. What is it that can connect to the فعل مضارع? Three things. The first one is أفعال الخمسة. This is just additional information. If you didn't understand it, there's nothing wrong. Because we're going to come to أفعال الخمسة. But the first thing that can happen to the فعل المضارع is that it turns into أفعال الخمسة. The second one is نون التوكيد. The نون of emphasis can enter the فعل المضارع. As you can see, the word was يذهب. The word was what? يذهب. نون التوكيد went into it. Plus نون التوكيد. So it added to the word, right? Then it became what? It equaled what? يذهبن. When it becomes يذهبن, which is the emphasis, نون التوكيد connects to it. It's no longer al-i'rab. It's another chapter that's not discussed in al-Ajrumiyyah. Does that make sense? Nunu niswa. What's the difference? What's nunu niswa? Nunu niswa is women. A lot of women. I want to say a lot of women came. So they. It turns out to be what? It's yad hab. Nah. Again, this noon is called noon al-niswa, which is the noon of many women, and noon al-tawqid, which is emphasis. يذهبن, you will leave and leave, and he will leave and leave, and you're emphasizing on it. صح? Yeah? No, we're not talking about ماضي because we say فعل المضارع. We're talking about فعل المضارع. فعل الماضي is not even in discussion at all. فعل الماضي is مبني. Leave it there. We're talking about mu'rab and al-i'rab. Yadhhabu, if nun al-tawqid connects to the ending of it, or a nun al-niswa, then it's no longer i'rab. And that's one of the things that can connect to it from the ending. And also, af'al al-khamsa. Niswa is nisa, women. It's also called nun al-inath. Those two names is given.
So we're saying that fi'l mudari' verbs that can be subject to i'rab, so the endings can change, except if there are certain endings which are five i'rab. So these five i'rab.
It's still i'rab, this one's still i'rab.
Yeah, so these cannot be, they've been now, so they cannot be subject to i'rab.
No, if al khamsa, right? It can be subject to i'rab with this one. These two can't. So if ever you see it with yadhabanna, don't say, and where's the adawatul nasb that went before it? For example, you're looking at the bat, right? It's got fatha on it. You're going to be looking for adawatul nasb. Don't trouble yourself, because it's not asl and not. This يَغْتَسِلْ بِآخِرِهِ شَيْءٍ. But all it does is just takes it from here and it puts it into another chapter of I'rab, the first one. And these two, they take it fully out of I'rab. There's an exception within that. That's صحيح. Correct. Yeah.
So this means that we can no longer do I'rab on them if you add the last two.
The last two, صحيح. Don't do I'rab of it at all. Just say مبني, مبني, مبني. It's one fixed haraka, yeah. If it's known in tawkid, it's always fixed haraka, which is fatah. And if it's known in niswa, it's fixed, it's always going to be sukoon. Yeah? It's also dhamma as well, yeah. But whatever that word is, it's not going to change from that. It's always going to be like that. I'rab is the one that changes based on context and situations. So that's the one that you should study, because it's the one that keeps changing. As for mabni, it doesn't change. No new tawkid. There's many places in the Quran, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. Hey, give me an emphasis where Allah emphasizes on something. لا تدخلن المسجد الحرام. لا تدخلن, you will enter and enter and enter المسجد الحرام. إن شاء الله آمنين محلقين رؤوسكم. لا تدخلن المسجد الحرام. تدخلن المسجد الحرام is what? It's an emphasis, right? لا أقطع عن أيديكم وأرجلكم من خلاف ولا أصلي بنكم في جذوع النخل. صح? So these ayats, there are many places in the Quran. You just learn it and you look for it. No, niswa is many women. You can use it for any verb. Any verb. You give me a verb, I'll tell you many women did it. It's just that when the person chooses to make it nunu niswa, it no longer is considered to be i'rab. So the fi'l mudari' alladhi lam yattasil, how many types of things did I say we can do i'rab of? Eight, right? I said eight things we do i'rab of, right? From the eight things that we do i'rab of, is one of them was al-fi'l mudari' alladhi lam yattasil bi akhri shay, sah? The reason why we said nothing can connect to it at the ending is because we're trying to avoid these two. Qira'ah, if I say. So if you want me to do it on the word qira'ah. So you say, yaqra'anna. Yeah? And if I want to make it nunu niswa, I say, yaqra'anna. Sah? Hakada. Any word you give me, I can do it like that. Wahalumma jarrah. You just go according to that way. Any other questions? No, it doesn't make it plural. No, not necessarily. It could just one person be. It could be. Like in all niswa is many women. Yeah.
So is it dependent, if it's plural or not, it's dependent on context?
It's depending on how you want to say something. You want to say something by emphasis, you can put it in there, no problem. In the fi'l mudari'. Does anyone? It becomes we. So now it becomes plural, sah. Yes.
How does it change? It changes.
It changes the word. So it puts a sukun on top of it. Or hadf. Ha, lam yadhab ha. Oh, no, it can't go before it. I can't, because this is mabni. That's mu'rab. The lam.
Yeah. But can you put it and it doesn't change? Or you can't even put it?
So, good question. Adawatul Jazmi and Adawatul Nasbi, they enter the what? That which is? Mu'rab. Do they only affect fi'ls which are mu'rab? Yes, they're the only ones that they affect. If it enters a word that is mabni, the word will still stay still, even if the lam is before it. It'll just look the same. It won't have any effect on it. So its presence and its absence will be the same. But if you want to negate, you can negate from the word, no problem. It just won't show. It won't show. It will not show. Look, brothers, let me explain something to you guys. The fi'l mudari' has three situations. Best when it comes to haraka. For example, the word yadhabu. What do you see at the ending of the word? Yeah? Dhamma, right? Okay. Lam and what? Lam yad hab. Lam lan yad haba. Look at the last. What happened? This is yadhabu. This is yadhab. And this is yadhaba. Are we all together? When it's got a dhamma, when it's a sukun. Look, the asal of the fi'l mudari' is, without anything gone before it, is a dhamma. It's a default position. How it always is. If you ever see fi'l mudari' that has a sukun on it, just look before it and say, you min adwat al-jazmi. Does that make sense? This lam affects it. Then lan, when it goes before it, it affects it as well. It makes it a fatha. So you say lan yadhaba. Are we all together? If lam or lan or even nothing goes before these guys, it doesn't change. That's what mabni means. If you put lan before this one right now, if you put lan or lam before it, it's going to look like that. That's why it's called mabni. These two, nothing can affect it. It remains the same. You know why it's called mabni, by the way? The reason why they called it mabni is because mabni is a building, and a building is structured and it's strong and it doesn't move. The building doesn't move, sah? Yeah, you can put any negation, but just doesn't get affected. We can have that discussion. Can you put la before it like that? And can instead of the lam before the fi'l mudari', can we put la before it? Lam yalid. Look what you said. Lam yalid. You put a sukun on it. Do you see my point? Lam yalid. You put a sukun on the word. It's yalidu originally. And then sukun went on it because lam went before it. Wahakada. This two, it no longer is i'rab. This is i'rab. I'rab means it's changing because of things that are going before it and after it. Sorry, before it. Like in these dudes, these guys. Lam yalid. Let's write it together. So, lam yalid. Walam yulat. Hey, what do you want from me? It changed. Of course it changed. The word was originally yalidu. There used to be a dhamma here. Aslan, yalidu. Lam came, and it became what? Lam yalid. Walam yulad. Because of the lam, that's it. Sah? What's the difference between yalid and yulad, sah? Hey, does anyone here can quickly tell us the difference? How, hey? So, lam yalid. It means what? What does it say in English? What do they translate as English? Ha. Yeah? The difference between the two, as Abdul Samad mentioned, is one is mabniyu lil ma'lumi and the other is mabniyu lil majhuli. Are we all together? One, the action is being done, we know who is doing it. Here, Allah did not give birth to any children, that's what it's been said. And he has not been given birth to. The one who did is not being mentioned here. That's the difference. Are we all together? You guys are going too deep on yourselves, and I'm going to answer it, and you're going to get confused more. Yeah? I'm going to answer. If you ask me, I'm going to. But it's going to go over you guys. What is mabniyul majhul? How many types of the word? Does that make sense? This is deep. It's a deep science. But it's good that you guys have a lot of questions. It shows that you're amazed with things. But it's good again that you're picking verses up and realizing that this verse has a relation with it. Hey, yeah? Any other questions? Yeah? Ask. Don't worry. I'm never tired of answering these questions. Hey? Some of you, I'm going to be asking you on the way out. Now, maybe your question, other people might benefit from it. It's better. You can ask me on the way out, no problem, but other people might benefit from it here as well. So, it might be so. Sometimes people ask me questions on the way, and I'm like, in my head, I don't say it to you because I don't want to break your heart. But in my head, I'm like, if he only asked that question in the class, other people could have benefited from it. Are we all together? So, hey, if you have a question now that you want to ask on the way, it's better to ask now so other people can benefit from it. أفعال الخمسة يمين. أفعال الخمسة is another thing. The difference between the فعل المضارع الذي لم يتصل بآخره شيء and أفعال الخمسة is one is معرب بالحركة and one is معرب بالحروف. They're both معرب, but the إعراب of this one is on the حركة and this one is on the حروف, a letter. As you can see, ألف is a letter, واو is a letter, and الياء is a letter. The i'rab of this one happens on the letters. And the other one, which is فعل مضارع الذي لم يتصل بآخر شيء, the i'rab happens to حركة. Does that make sense? That's the only difference. But they're both i'rab. Any other questions? I think that's enough for you guys, because it's too much to understand more than that. But what I do encourage you all is to go home and read, and write, and read. There's a video of me online going through this exact same class. Yeah? It's online. I used the board as well, in London. It was in London, huh? Yeah. There's one on board, online. Yeah, it's Tuhfat al-Saniyah. The Tuhfat al-Saniyah, write it down, it's on the board. And there's one I didn't do on the board, which I just quickly went over that one. That's a bit, it's too fast. That was a Dawra Ilmiya one. The one I used the board is better for you. I... Go ahead.
We say, huwa ya sabana. Even both.
Hey.
If I have to say, even differently both, then I will say, huwa ya sabana. Is that correct? Huwa ya sabana.
Ha. So let me just, one point I want to point out. He said, huwa yadhabu. First of all, does he have to bring the pronoun of huwa? Do you have to say, huwa yadhabu? Can you just drop that pronoun of huwa and just say yadhabu? Because huwa is already present in the fi'l yadhabu. Huh? And the more your words are summarized, the better. So let's get rid of the huwa. The question here is, can we say yadhabanna? We can. Sah? That's one view as well. Huwa yadhabu, he is going. That's a form of emphasis, sahih. Sah? It is. Like generally people are using it in a normal context. They're not trying to, like people say, anta tadhabu. Are you with me? You can just say tadhabu. It's already mukhatabah. You're addressing a person. And the more your words are summarized, the more eloquent it becomes. The more eloquent. I don't know if I told you guys this story. We were in Egypt and we were seeking knowledge at that time. Or we were meant to be seeking knowledge. And a brother came to us and he said, look, brothers, every day we can't be studying and learning. How about we play a game called Ludo? You guys know the dice game. No, please don't play it, okay? Don't waste your time. So we said, okay, yeah, let's go get it. So we went to the shop, and our plan was to get a dice. The problem is no one knows what a dice is. We don't know the translation of the word dice. You'll know what a dice is, right? We don't know what a dice is. So we went to the shop, and when we went to the shop, we want to tell him, please give us a dice. We all looked at each other. Do you know what a dice is? No. Do you know what a dice is? No, no. If we don't have a dice, we cannot what? We can't play the game. So one of the brothers, was it me? I don't know. But one of us went forward and we said, Nuridu shay. Lahu sittatu ajnah. We want something that has six sides. Ala kulli janahin minha nuqat. يَلْعَبُ بِهَا الصِّبْيَانِ The kids play with it. When we finished, he said to us, صَدَقَ اللَّهُ الْعَظِيمُ He said to us what? In other words, what he's trying to say is the Arabic that we were speaking. And then he said to us, this is the Arabic of Hassan al-Basri and al-Awza'i. You know, this is the Arabic of what? Because we were saying, شَيْءٌ You know, we're going, our Arabic was too long-winded. After all of that long speech, he still didn't understand what we were saying. This is the problem of eloquence, sah? It's important. When Allah gives you balagha and you're able to get your point across, it's not how much things that you say, it's how short and concise your words are. Sah? Right? So, I never forget that day. And it really shows you that the world is trying to move away from speaking that Arabic. Speaking that what? The Arabic that the Quran came down with. People are trying to walk away from that and try to learn other different dialects. And when you do try to speak that language, they always, oh, it's very common. They will say to you, Malik, what happened? Or they laugh at you in the Arab world. They will laugh at you if you speak that type of Arabic. But it's one thing that our language is going to have over all languages is that the Fusha can never go because of the Quran and the Sunnah. It can never go. I remember, subhanAllah, in one of my classes in linguistics in university in the UK, the professor who's teaching us said to us, when a language is connected to a scripture, it will never perish, like Islam. Wallahi, I remember. She goes, English will change. It can change. She said, one of the questions she asked is that, she said, the English spoken by the Indians, what gives that one less priority than the English that's spoken by the English? Does it make sense? If more of the English people, more of the population of India, there's more number of people in India who speak in English in that way than there is in England, why is England's English correct and Indians' English is not? Does it make sense? The pronunciation, basically. Because none of them are connected to a scripture. Or the English that's spoken in America. Or the English that's spoken in Canada. Why is the one in Canada not right and the English? Do you see my point? They can't claim that. But we can. We can because of the Quran. Because in Sunnah we say, this is right. This is how it is. That's what's going to hold people down whether they speak right or wrong. Sah? No. Yeah.